What is up, you guys? Glitches here, and welcome back to God of War Ragnarok. If you caught my last episode, we got pretty much all of the side quests and Vanaheim done, and I mentioned that we had this area to go to in Alfheim regarding the elves that we had to do. So I took the liberty of teleporting over here to the entrance, and I figured we'd do this side quest and get this one cleared out this episode. So let's move on forward here.
It looks as though the Light Elves sealed off this section of the Barrens. Why?
Luckily for us, a very considerate goddess has enhanced our magic chisel, and we can unseal it.
My, that is lucky.
The Forbidden Sands lay beyond.
Contested territory, according to Bela. And another storm to endure.
I remember when Freya and I traveled to this realm as children. The desert was healthy and full of life back then. I can't help but fear that era has ended for good and our efforts here are futile.
It's a fair concern. Healing this land will take more than a pair of singing half-goofa. But I have to believe, in the long run, we're doing right by Alfheim.
I was gonna say, I probably should have just brought my sled. I want to be manually running this whole thing. The Forbidden Sands.
Well, best we start looking for a way underground.
Keep a lookout for a cave!
Song of the Sands. We'll do a perimeter check like we did last time.
That's the beauty of a locked door. It could be anything. Monsters, treasure. Though in our luck, it'll be a bit of both.
Two more artifacts for this area.
Nasty hit! You all right, brother?
Yeah. Rot!
Oh, no way. Did not mean to do that. Right when I killed him, too. It's unfortunate.
That's frost in my neck, stump.
Better be worth it.
I hope Freyr will appreciate our work here in the desert. I wonder if he knows how poorly this realm has fared in his absence.
Aye. Hearing the Song of the Sands again is a rare privilege, even if it's only a solo act.
Or a duet, once this Hofgufa is free. This architecture, it is not of the Dark Elves.
An abandoned ancient settlement, by the looks of it. Built long before the Lightwell's creation.
More hive matter as well.
I'd say we're on the right track then.
Reach it from down here.
This kind of hive material is sensitive to sound. When I last came here with you and Atreus, I assumed the absence of Alfheim's light was an aberration.
Aye, and as far as the Dark Elves are concerned, it's that light column in the center of the temple that's the aberration. Just look at how old some of these surfaces are. Far older than the Lightwell, or even our trapped Hofgufa for that matter.
That's quite the empathetic perspective, Mimir.
Well, dangle from a burly god's backside for a few winters, and you'll find yourself looking for all sorts of new perspectives.
Back here!
Underneath the barons, do they?
Territory changes hands often in Alfheim, or so it appears.
Big Vier did mention that these ruins have historical significance for the Light Elves. I assume they're only here to keep intruders out.
Well, at least they tried.
Come on.
I suspect the corpse below would disagree. Let's continue, shall we?
Dazzling display once. The skies of Alfheim filled with their song.
I imagine it's the lack of fresh light that's caused this pair to grow abnormally large. No use in having babies if there's nothing for them to feed on.
Trying to protect their children from a harsh world. I can relate.
Hmm.
we were supposed to do this side quest a while ago. Stuff's really easy to kill here. Another one.
They face once free.
What choice do you speak of?
The life cycle of the Hakuta. In order to breed, they must pass on their light to their children.
Then without light, they will die.
I suppose that's all any of us can hope for now. That our death has a purpose. That we can live on through our children. Given another chance.
Back to the surface, then.
Heavy runic attack.
Creatures. It reminds me of a story.
Does it?
There once was a blacksmith whose king commanded him to construct a box that could contain all the evils of the world. But no metal could hold such a power. So the blacksmith used the flame.
Kratos, is this a story meant to ease my grief?
Perhaps it is just a story. A way to pass the time.
I appreciate the sentiment, but Well, your stories...
What about my stories?
I wouldn't exactly call them a comfort.
Fair. Mimir is the better storyteller.
Now, don't sell yourself short, brother. You've come a long way from the days of laconic fables.
It's okay. Finish your story, Kratos.
The blacksmith's daughter was the key to unlocking the box. He died trying to protect her from those who would open it.
Well, at least it's a relatable story.
Much easier. Sitting here trying to spin it from the ground floor. I might have missed something. Like this.
Years we've overstayed our welcome in Alfheim.
Time to end this story.
Almost there. Got them both unlocked. Song of the Sands completed.
If my stories are no comfort, take solace in knowing you did what you thought was best for your son's safety. Even these creatures know There is little choice for a parent. You are not alone.
Now they're together.
I'm not, am I? And now neither are they.
That's pretty cool.
Thank you, Kratos. This land sings once more. We've done good here.
No rush to leave yet, is there? Who knows what kind of adventures await us in a freshly lit barrens?
And they just disintegrated. Cool.
Of my brother. How quaint.
Wonderful.
That's odd. The runes are dark.
What purpose does all this serve, other than a testament to my brother's vanity?
Difficult to say without an inscription, but it looks like the elves built this place together, light and dark. Which means this would have been their first act of cooperation in generations. A far cry from lasting peace, but perhaps it served as a monument, one that symbolizes the potential for peace.
This statue may have survived Freya's absence, but a truce clearly did not. Monuments are useless to those who ignore their message.
He didn't create a truce through diplomacy alone. His godhood, his very presence is what healed this land and allowed peace to take root. But once he left, he had to have known what would happen.
Well, he had good reason to leave. Some jackass convinced his sister to marry a madman.
He said monuments are useless. Why was he useless?
It was hidden for some time. Perhaps now it can serve as a reminder.
Aye. Nothing reminds people of their history like chiseled, well-lit marble.
These crystals contain their own light.
You're right. Normally, we'd have to provide our own. Perhaps slotting a crystal on the opposite side could shed some light on this mystery. Looks like we can read the inscription now as well. In honor of the Enlightened One, may his gift of light shine eternal.
Light from the crystals. It is in the sand now.
Would you look at that? Freyr's gift endures after all. Or should I say, his presence?
You are not Freyr.
Runic summon. It's a lower level one. So we got two side quests done here. The only one we haven't done is the one we originally came here to do. I'm assuming we should have access to.
The peace was fragile. Surely a bit of extra light in the desert isn't enough to make it last.
Before I met Faye, I could not imagine a life of peace.
Oh, there's a lot of stuff around here. It's a big area.
In our travels to Jotunheim, I found peace on my own. It remains my responsibility to make it last.
Perhaps the elves will find peace again one day, even without Freyr's guidance.
His presence continues to guide them, whether they realize it or not.
Oh, another fruit location.
Another carving from Yari and Somar.
There's probably another ingredient around here, brother.
It is an ingredient from the recipe. How did they reach this realm?
Oh, they were well versed in realm travel. You see, Yari raised a Midgardian warrior. Meant to fight in the family's wars, find a wife, die for glory. But he rejected it. He left.
He followed his own path.
I wouldn't be surprised if we found their mark in other realms as well.
Another horn. Sky's just filled with the little spirits now.
Perhaps we can bring these two animals back to Vanaheim, or Midgard even. Specky and Spanner could use the company. We have kennels.
It would not go well for them. Once a predator becomes accustomed to a land, it is cruel to move them.
I suppose you're right. It just seems lonely out here.
It is peaceful. They have each other.
One of the flowers.
Yeah. Yet another sleeping beast. The handiwork of Alvi Stonefoot.
Don't have the ability to unlock those guys yet. But at least now we know. Alright, keep on moving. Oh, come on, Freya.
Freya, you once survived a giant's corpse to a... stop a certain fight that we won't talk about. Could you call on that power again?
Maybe. Do you have a massive giant's corpse for me to revive?
No.
Well, there you go.
A gravestone. No doubt a berserker awaits.
Easy peasy. We'll save the berserkers for later.
I must say, I think we make a good team. With my brain, Kratos is brawn, and my lady's,
wisdom? Magic? Ability to tolerate you for long periods of time?
I was going to say brutality.
That works.
In this way, so this is technically...
Freya, do you mind picking up that story about your brother? I think you said a giant had appeared in Vanaheim.
That's right.
Brother, wait. Do you notice that?
A light elf statue in the desert. Odd.
On top of ancient elven ruins? I'd have to agree. Nasty hit! You all right, brother?
Go!
Oh, so close. Come, come, come. A ricochet point I haven't seen yet. That should have been a hit. Okay, so this is literally just a specific angle that I haven't gotten yet. Do I need to be up higher? This is a tricky one. Can't climb. Go! needs a ricochet back off of the first one. Could it be? Maybe I have to throw it from up here.
Ah, another of Cavassier's poems.
Ay, ay, ay. Berserker. Entrance to the burrows.
You know, Freyr loved to breed Gulan pups in Vanaheim. I wonder if these two are the descendants of the Gulan he brought here long ago.
That explains how they got to the desert. Another gift for the Dark Elves.
Jewelry.
Oh? Put it on one of my horns. Let's see if I can pull it off.
No.
That's all my brother's tributes.
Prefer we hang on to them?
Do what you will. If Freyr didn't have to take them when he left us, he wouldn't want to sell them to the dwarves.
Alright, here we go.
An elven library.
An archive of knowledge.
No sign of the Light Elves.
For now.
Maybe they've left for the day. We can browse at our leisure.
A treasure map?
These texts alone are not enough to end the Elven War. But restricting their access only serves those who wish to prolong it.
Taking a page out of Odin's book.
Aye. Quite the advantage for the Light Elves.
Gotten Tower Treasure Map. Artifact upgrade.
This book is sealed, but there is an inscription. Consul.
Bigvir spoke of an exile of the same name. Odds are he'd like a gander at that particular text.
All this knowledge of their ancestors. Their shared history, poetry. Just sitting here. Forgotten. What a waste.
Here.
Another one of Dvalin's diagrams.
You spoke of his conscience.
Aye. We saw that the Aesir would likely use his powerful weapons to cut down his fellow dwarves, so he ripped out his design pages and scattered them.
And what of him?
Well, the Allfather found out. He wasn't terribly pleased. It appears the librarian would like a word.
Lata Framborg.
Sounds like she wants that journal back.
No.
You can't have it.
Use a shield strike,
Switching arrows. They're healing.
I don't think so.
Yourself, thought Yankivita. Helga brought him up.
She thinks she's protecting them by hiding all this knowledge away.
Our ally wishes to read this journal. We are taking the book.
Why, thank you.
I'm impressed. Thought you were going to end her.
When last we traveled here, after Faye passed, I killed an elf of great importance. The ramifications were dire for his people.
You mind picking up that story about your brother? I think you said a giant. To appear in Vanaheim.
That's right.
Let this wait. Stay alert.
Treasure chest. So we got all the Alfheim ones now.
And it's not happening.
Oh, hello.
Guess is as good as mine. Imprisoning a drake. Can't decide whether to be impressed or horrified.
Either way, it is over now.
Can be used to craft dragon scaled armor. Interesting. Well, that was pretty cool. Don't know why it won't let us collect that, because pretty sure we already got it. Yeah. Nice. Well, we killed our first Drake. I think that's pretty much all the quests in this area. 11, 19, Odin's Raven. We're missing one Odin's Raven, a couple Norn chests, Berserker gravestones we haven't done. Got almost everything in here. Norn's chest, Odin's Raven. A couple random things throughout here, but yeah, I think that's a good place to end the episode. If you guys found this video helpful, be sure to smash that like button, comment down below, and as always, if you want to keep up to date with all the future episodes of the series, consider subscribing and turn on that notification bell. Till the next time, you guys, hope you all had a great day, and thanks for watching. You